All right, so today's the 30th of March. It's a Monday. And so this is kind of the week that I kind of change a little bit of how my lifestyle is after the spring break, basically when we transition into the virtual classes. So last week has always been basically 90% or 95% of staying at home, cooking, and the other 5% is basically just me going for groceries and just going to my friend's place for dinner, and that's like really little. So today, on Monday, I kind of started really differently. I had to go to work in the food science building where I work as a research assistant for a food packaging professor. So I was just helping out with the project, and I had to leave my house around before 11. And on my way, I was just cycling. It was a really nice weather, but it was really deserted. Usually, it would be prime time for students coming out of classes. The general before COVID-19, you would see a lot of students walking around. You would see quite a number of cars, SkyRide buses definitely, students waiting at the bus stop, and it was a lot of people. Yeah, and usually when I cycle to classes, there would be a lot of people that I would have to avoid. But today, when I went to the food science building, it was really deserted. It was completely empty. There were a couple of cars, like just one or two, three countable numbers, but absolutely almost nobody was on campus. You don't see anybody waiting at a bus stop. I don't even think I saw any SkyRide buses. I definitely did not see anybody in Central Campus. No one was there, and all the buildings were locked. So I had to call up my professor to let me in. So there was a scene that was really different from before COVID-19 and what is happening right now. So even in the building, it was really empty. There were really minimum number of people that were working. I only worked with my professor, but then we had like a new protocol, like social distancing, staying 6 feet away from everyone, washing hands, being the extra precaution from even at when I'm working in the lab. I didn't really see a lot of people working either, just like a couple, like two other professors and one other employee, but that's about it. There weren't a lot of people there. It was kind of tough because when my professor went for lunch break, I didn't bring any food, and I would just go to DMU and grab a snack, but DMU's closed and there weren't a lot of food options unless I call up for delivery, which would take up 30 minutes. It would definitely cost a little extra for the tips, for delivery fee. And yeah, that problem came about again. Basically, I didn't have that easy of an access of food anymore compared to before COVID-19. So that came about again. And this was really interesting is when I left to go back to my apartment to catch another class meeting, discussion meeting, online meeting. On my way back, I was going through Central Campus, and I was really surprised because I wouldn't expect it that no one would be at Central Campus. I actually expected it to be the same scene as this morning, but apparently not. There were a couple of group of people hanging out on Central Campus, and I don't know if that's okay, but I at least saw three groups of people, families, groups on Central Campus just chilling on the lawn, and then a few more group of people hammocking together. And it wasn't just a solo single person, it was at least a group of like three people together. So that was kind of surprising because I know that yeah, people do go still try to go out, but I was kind of surprised that it's happening in Central Campus. There are quite a number of people jogging around, cycling, no, not cycling, just kind of jogging and bringing their dogs out. There were quite a number of them, just like about four people, that I've seen jogging, for the short amount of time that I was out. So that was kind of the observation I've seen for the short amount of time that I was out of my apartment. So, oh, actually, one more thing. There was also still a house of, like, just by my apartment of people actually playing beer pong outside of their house in their front lawn. And that's just not really right. I don't think it's that right because it should be so, like, we should be practicing social distancing and the protocols for to prevent COVID-19. But yeah, I'm pretty sure there were a group of at least five people playing beer pong together and just basically with red cups, and I don't know if they were drinking or anything, but yeah, that happened. That was kind of the observation I've seen so far for today that when I went out. So that was kind of an interesting thing to actually see people be still a group of people still out and about doing stuff. So yeah, that's for today on Monday. We'll see what goes on tomorrow then.